Hello everyone, Melcadrien here, and I'm here to show you Galaxy of Pen and Paper. Before I get to talking about the game, I'd like to thank the developers for providing me a digital key of this game for me to show you guys for free. Thank you. Now, what is Galaxy of Pen and Paper? Well, simply put, what I can say in the simplest of terms is that it draws its main aspect from, well, Knights of Pen and Paper, except it is with sci-fi settings and a lot of different and new mechanics. Anyways, here we are with the main area, our spaceship. We move from area to area, but this is our home base. When you get to it anyways, you don't start at the spaceship. I'm reading here that the trooper class wears space armor model E3778Q1. Then what does that mean? That there'll be an E778Q2 someday? This is so confusing. Forget I mentioned it. Okay, focus on the game, everyone. Yes, this is our spaceship. Well, actually, it's not a being on an actual spaceship. This is our mental projection of the game world. And here are our party members, which I have created. A trooper named Evan, and a... what were you again? You're a hacker, if I remember right. And a hacker named Vic. They have varying stats depending on what character type you picked from and what species you picked from. Yes, I chose humans at the beginning, mainly because I just want to start off with some humans. There are some other species that you can start off with, like green or simian. That's pretty much the only ones that I can think of. And there are other classes to go with it. Anyways, enough jabbering. Let's do some adventuring. And one good way to do that is by creating a mission. Let's see, I will not do any hunting or intercepting or collecting. We are going to be doing a campaign quest. Because plots. And you probably would want to see the plot more than us hunting down some enemies, blowing up ships, or collecting materials. Yes, we can blow up ships in space, and we can actually get materials to make money. If you really want to. I just got an email saying some new RPG modules are out. RPG modules allow us to use new planet types, new monsters, even new classes. Let's order one right now! I can only buy one with my allowance though, so choose wisely. Yes, the GM in this game pretty much lives on an allowance. Let's see, choose one RPG module to unlock its contents. Let's see, a Savage Hunt, Medtech Sans Frontiers, Parley and Negotiations, and Wooga! Fire Planet, Heavy Questline, Fire Enemies, New Skills, Negotiator, Medtech, Savage. Oh, let's go with Parley and Negotiations. Okay, good choice. I'm downloading the files. It's nice that that this is using an old CRT monitor. Wow, oh, that is very retro. You can try this module's exclusive mission whenever you feel like it. Playing a space setting is a really different experience, huh? I'm glad we're such an open-minded group of roleplayers. And some people on the online message board said this setting has porks. Are we gonna fight some? Maybe. You've got the whole of the verse ahead of you. But hey, Evan, don't get carried away on those message boards. You might spoil yourself some of these surprises I've got in store. Yeah, it's more fun if you don't know what creatures may appear. Though, actually, I guess I have to admit I've been chatting to one of or two people myself. Just be careful, okay? I'd like to keep metagaming to a minimum. Anyway, that's enough time in the real world. Back to the Sandstar, everyone! Yes, you can name your ship. The generic name, the name that it chooses for you is Frogget, but not Frogget, something frog. But you know what? I chose to just go with, oh, the sand star, because it sounded appropriate for how we got it. When you play the game, you'll find out why I said that. Alright, the plot thickens. Episode 2. The Wrath of Beta? Is this a beta map? We have space for one more person on our servers. We should invite someone to play. Yeah, narrating for more people would be cool. Not too many people, though. Alright, I guess we can add a new role player. Now you get to see how they are actually created. Let's see. Here are what we have right now. We have Slayers. Well, these are all the characters that we can pick from. I've already picked some of them. So, yeah. The Achiever, Show-Off, Slayer, Socializer, Storyteller, and Romantic. Let's see. I already have two men in the group. So let's get a woman. Let's see. We have an engineer, supports party and blows stuff up. Bounty hunter. Let's go with bounty hunter. I'm gonna stick with bounty hunter power. Actually, slows down. Or deal damage to a line. I think I will go with well, I guess one thing I could do is I could min-max. Although mind wouldn't be too well. Yeah, let's do that. A human romantic. Yeah, let's go with that. No. Discount to buy weapons and armor upgrades, huh? Yeah, let's go with romantic. And I'll name this role player Susanna. Oh, thanks for inviting me in, everyone. Welcome. You guys met each other over in a space cantina and now traveling together. Now your characters know each other and we can resume playing. I was very charming in that cantina, by the way. Of course you were. Now let's get back to the game already. Alright, let's do some questing. You suddenly receive a holo call.
Yes, this is Sandstar. I got your holo ID from Professor Aran.
This is, indeed, the Sandstar.
Cool, very cool. I'll tell you what, I need to get to Thermanga, but a freaky cool like me... You know, I can't go running around in just any ship. You get that? I'm gonna ride a cool ship. And I hear that your cool ship is heading that way.
Let's see. Sure, we don't charge much.
Charge? I'm used to traveling, you know, for free.
For free? The Sandstorm won't auto-repair itself for free. What could possibly make us take you anywhere for free?
Traveling for free, well, it's one of the perks of being the president of the galaxy.
President?
Yeah, Breadbox Bezalaw, president of the galaxy. Don't you cats recognize me? Look, here's a presidential transport order.
He uploads a fire to you, which...
rolls.
Looks very official.
Let's go, chop chop! Presidents can't wait.
Gee, okay then. But something smells like dry dolphins here.
Come pick me up in Neo Tokyo, alright? Breadbox Bezalaw, Galactic President has first...
ordered you to carry him around on the Sandstar, and no one refuses a presidential order. Alright, let's go down to Neo Tokyo. Yes, I'm actually at Neo Tokyo right now. And we can actually travel around this planet if we so want to. There's Neo Tokyo, there's the Kaneda Prefecture. The funny thing is, I never knew about this whole Kaneda help me thing that... This is a long time thing that I was trying to figure out when I was watching someone's video. I never knew what Kaneda was. Mainly because I never watched the movie Akira, apparently. Anyways, as you enter the spaceport, President Beezlehump immediately approaches you.
Hey, you cats actually came.
Nice, nice.
I'm ready to be escorted to Thermaga on official business. Come on, a president has no time to lose.
He promptly aborts your ATV. We better escort our political passenger and be done with this.
Alright, let us go back to the Sandstar. And then travel through space! Yes, space.
Let's go to the... looks like the Roddenberry system. Let's go. Why is the Sandstar rattling like that?
I don't know, Susanna. I'll
run some tests. Something weird's going on. Stay alert, everyone.
That's cute.
Alright, to the Roddenberry system. Nice effects. To Thermaga. This doesn't look like a interesting planet. You land on Thermaga. There's nothing here. Such a barren place. Hey, Mr. Press, Hey, where is he?
I think it was in the bathroom.
You see the Sandstar up there, slowly starting to leave Thermaga. And you get a holo call.
Hey, don't you cats worry, I'll take real good care of your spaceship. If I could figure out how to fly this thing, that is.
Ah, let's hurry up before he leaves us stranded here. You quickly return to the Sandstar's bridge, but find no trace of Breadbox. Let's look around, he can't have gone too far. You find Breadbox on the cargo bay.
This really isn't the engine room, is it?
Everyone, roll the mind check. You pass. Wait a minute. The galaxy is run by a council of representatives of every race. It doesn't have a president.
Catching me red-handed wasn't enough for you to figure that out. I'll just do this the hard way. Come on, robots, time to go to work.
Robots sprout from his luggage. And now it's time for some combat. Ooh, four enemies, huh? Let's see. I want to start with... oh, one thing I'd like to note. You see that white thing in front of their red bars? That's shields. Yes. It's sci-fi. Of course everyone's gotta have some shields. Let's see. Let us... yes, poison him, do a burst attack on him,
nice,
oh, he recharges shields, huh? Let's see, oh, I forgot to give you some skills, oh well, we'll deal with that later, go wrench him.
Yes!
It failed its save. Alright. Next up, poison this one. Continuing that burst attack. Jeez, he really likes making sure that they recharge. No matter. That's another one. Yes! Poison still works! Well, they marked her. Oh, looks like that one just resisted it. Unfortunately, when you resist a something, well, an ailment, it goes away. Kind of a interesting mechanic. If they failed it, they get the effect for another round. If they resist it, the effect ends. Let's see. You're probably dead next turn, so you know what? Yes! Destroy him with the computer! And he's out of power. No problem, I have some distilled water. Continue your assault. He really likes recharging their shields. No problem. Use force slowdown on him. Well, everyone's marked. Yes, he's been computed. All right, now time to take care of the president. Ow, that's got some splash damage to it. Why don't you slow down for a bit, hmm? Bam! If in pain, take more damage. Else, take damage. Ow! Oh, he's immune to slow. Okay. Well, I'll just program some poison on him. It's not like he's gonna be complaining about it. Oh yeah. Oh, and he summons a robot. You missed. You missed. Okay, well. Ah, team attack. And heat signature. Yeah, that's a passive ability which activates with a certain percentage. Alright, time to clean up. And take this imposter to Space Interpol. You know what's nice? In Knights of Pen and Paper, I believe in order to actually heal, you have to go to an inn, which costs money. All you have to do for this one is go to your ship. One bread box suitcase. You've seen bread box using this case before. Its plating is suitable as an effective shield. Ricochets bullets too. Ooh, that's nice.
You cats pack a wallop, I'll give you that.
He presses a button on his belt. Ooh, shaky. The ship went dead.
Being stranded in space and freezing to death is totally not a cool thing to do.
That was a security measure. Oh great, another killer robot. Vic Companion, do not confuse categories. I am this ship's linker.
Aeon, are you on the ship? Do you cats have a death wish or something? Suddenly this has turned out to be way more of a hassle than I'd originally intended. Keep your ship. I'm happy with an escape pod.
He escapes on a less than ideal vehicle for the conditions of outer space. Escorting Breadbox taught you all you need to know how to perform escort missions.
Ah, juju flop.
Hey, language. Sorry, Vic. I suppose that an introduction is in order. I protect the systems, manage communications, and am enabled to fly the Sandstar for you. The last dice you installed reactivated me. Oh. Die droid, welcome aboard. An AI, is this safe? Okay, actually, these character choices have an effect, which means that whoever you choose gets an XP bonus. Yeah, I kind of didn't notice that until I started, well, seeing that they gained some XP. Susanna could probably use it. Oh, that was easier than I expected. Thank you. I look forward to helping you on all on your travels. So, can you tell us where this ship was made? Where it's from? My memory banks are badly corrupted, Fit Companion. There's a small chance my files could be reconstituted with the aid of more dice. So, dice are the key to unlocking this mystery, huh? Also, while I am part of the Sandstar, I am also a separate entity. However, to reduce the stress for you, you can give me a name to which you can address me. Yeah, you look like a tadpole. Yeah, no. I'm using my creativity here. Give me a moment. I'm suddenly reminded of that. So you know what? I'll go with that. Link. No, not the character Link. From now on, you shall be known as Link. Link, I like it. It is time to, as you would say, hit the proverbial hyperspace bypass. Yay, mission complete! Woo! And now we are fully healed. And we have more space to explore. We can explore various planets, or we can actually fight a ship. I actually want to fight a spaceship where I don't want to blow up. Also, you saw that dice roll there? That was a roll on whether there was going to be an encounter of some sort. Oh, there actually isn't any there. Well, darn. I still want to show you one other mechanic, so I am going to have to go to one of these hostile ships. That's a lot of HP. Oh well. This is space combat. When you fight enemies on space, this is what happens. You roll the dice to get however many AP, and if it really is bad, you can use a consumable, if you have one, to re-roll that dice. If it ever actually works. Looks like it didn't get too well on that one, so let us just pull that energy. Oh, our enemy is using a D8. Well, this is going to make things difficult, and we have no way to escape either. Just do a basic attack. A couple basic attacks. Try and whittle down their armor. Okay. Let's fire again. Repair our hull. Come on. Give me a good roll here. Okay, pull my power. Ow. Oh. Dang. Nice. Nice combination. You wake up in the Sandstar's medbay after all that mess is done with. You lost some cash due to the Sandstar's repairs. Oh, come on. Can we get some good free repairs? I haggled with the engineers since the auto repair did at least half the job. and that knowledge puts my mind at ease. You're a solid AI, Link. And that's what happens should we fail. And it looks like I lost some reputation as a result of that. Dang. Anyways, reputation actually has a use because, well, as you can see, space savings, analytical strategy, deep scan, quick fingers. The higher our reputation, the better stuff we can get. But that's pretty much what a taste of what Galaxy of Pen and Paper has to show. There's probably a whole lot more that I am not showing you right now, mainly because, well, this is just the first few hours of me playing this game, and I still haven't gotten real far into this. Much like Chroma Squad, this is a real nice game, another game that they have created. And Knights of Pen and Paper. Though, Knights of Pen and Paper... Well, let's just say when it came to Knights of Pen and Paper, near mostly the end, it came to a, mileage may vary thing. But, if you're looking for a good long play of a game, Galaxy of Pen and Paper and any of the other games that they have created, it's probably worth a good play. It is worth a good play, anyways. Once again, I'd like to thank the developers for providing me a digital key of this game for me to show you guys for free. This game is awesome. You guys rock. Now, I am Melcadrien, and this has been my impressions of Galaxy of Pen and Paper. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, comment down below, follow me on Twitter and or Tumblr, and support me on Patreon. You don't have to. Every little bit of support does help, though. You all have a wonderful day, and happy gaming.